I'm Rattan Lal. I'm professor of soil science at the Ohio State University. There are two terms. One is soil quality and functionality, and the other is soil health. In Europe, the term soil quality and functionality is used mostly what soil can do. Soil health is a very specific term. It refers to the biological processes in soil that affect food nutritional quality. And these are microbial processes primarily. Why it is so important? Because the health of soil determines the health of the plants that grow into it, the nutritional uptake by plants, the quality of the protein content, and many other nutritional value of the plants are affected by those soil processes. And since plants are the primary producers, animals consume those plants, and human depend on the animal produce as well as on the plant produce. So human health also depends on that. And along with human and animal health, the ecosystems itself, what soil transpires into the atmosphere. Is it CO2, is it CH4, is it nitrous oxide, or are there other gases which also impact ecosystem health? So there is a strong link between soil health, plant health, animal health, human health, and ecosystem health. We think that 2 to 3 billion people worldwide are suffering from hidden hunger, malnutrition, not the calorie, malnutrition. And that is the cause of concern. So soil degradation has a strong adverse impact on human health from many perspectives. One other part that I should mention, very important, is that 90 to 95% of all antibiotics consumed by human and animals come from microbes in soil. So contaminating and polluting soils where those microbes are being contaminated, even applying sometime manure which has been given antibiotic, can have impact on the soil microbial population. So we should be very careful how we treat soil, because it is a living entity. Mostly farmers are very intelligent. They understand very well what works and what does not work. But like everybody else, sometimes when we ignore soil processes for short-term gains, either because of desperateness, like the resource-poor farmers in developing countries, or sometimes in commercialized agriculture where you must make sure that your all the bills are paid and economic profitability is there, people do make shortcuts. And in those shortcuts, there can be a damage to the soil. So I think the thing to do is to make sure that the farmers understand not to take soils for granted, not to do anything that can jeopardize soil health on a long-term basis, either by putting pollutants or by putting overuse of what we call indiscriminate use of chemicals, pesticides, herbicides, fertilizer, indiscriminate. That means not judicious. Due to some reason, you do not apply them properly. Soil management, soil health improvement should be just like any other health issue, like human health we are talking about. I want to mention one thing from the United States perspective, which perhaps from the European point of view may be interesting. We have a law that water health quality affects human health. So anybody who pollutes water is penalized. We have a law that air quality affects human health. Anybody who pollutes air is also told by EPA, Environment Protection, that this is criminal. There is no law that says soil health is also important to human health. So any polluter of soil health should also be penalized. I hope that the world community, world governments, including European Community and European Commission and European Parliament, establishes law that soil health is important to human health and to environment. So there should be legal reasons how the soil should be protected, preserved, restored, and improved for generations to come. and that's a very important part. I hope it will happen. Those laws do not exist anywhere, and they must.